Littlewood's Cup semi-final second leg between Luton Town and West Ham. On the face of it, West Ham would need the biggest upset since Custer's last stand to go through. Three down they were from the home leg. Luton, of course, won the trophy last April against Arsenal, saw themselves tonight just 90 minutes from a return to Wembley. Be interesting to see how the two sides approach the match. Luton, odds-on favourites. West Ham, virtually written off. Our commentator, Alan Parry.
Well, West Ham face a near impossible dilemma. They must go on attack and try to reduce their three-goal deficit, but if they were to concede another goal, it would surely finish them off. Well, they picked a team to reflect their difficult task. David Kelly is recalled up front. George Parris replaces Alan Dickens in midfield to allow Paul Ince some more attacking goal. Back to Priest. Really having it in.
We're going over to ITN now for a news report.
At least five people have died and more than 50 have been injured after two passenger trains collided this afternoon in Purley in Surrey. Some witnesses say the accident happened when the 1250 Horsham to Victoria train crossed from a local line to a fast track, where it collided with the 1217 Littlehampton to Victoria. It happened just north of Purley station.
this Wednesday night on BBC One continues with Sports Night, introduced by Steve Ryder.
Now the FA Cup, West Ham at Norwich, and in one respect the Hammers have already had a successful day. 24 hours before the transfer deadline, they've signed a player who isn't cup-tied and is also a firm favourite at Upton Park.
Alvin Martin. Oh, that's a good ball. McAvennie, clean through, round the goalkeeper, Frank McAvennie, 2-0. Thoroughly well deserved.
McAvennie, who rejoined West Ham from Celtic today for a club record fee of £1.25 million. And if West Ham win their quarter-final replay at Norwich tonight, well, he's available for the semi-final.
All veils and misty, streets are blue. Almond looks that chill divine. Some silken moment goes on forever, and we're leaving broken hearts behind. You mystify me. I need perfection. Selection that tangles me to keep me alive in all that exists, when none has your beauty. I see your face and I will survive.
Take me down to the paradise, to the world of grass, to the green of the girls I'm pretty. I want
checkered flag. What a fool running across the course. A raving lunatic. But Nigel Mansell has won the Brazilian Grand Prix. The first Grand Prix of 1989. The most exciting one we have seen for years.
Over the weekend we have obviously a lot of problems. Warm up this morning, I only did one lap and it was very disappointing. But this afternoon, what can I say except it's the most laps the car has done ever in the history of its life.
Himself.
The time has come.
to yonder blue. The western desert lives and breathes in 45 degrees.
The time has come to say face fair, to pay the rent, to pay our share.
The crush intensifies. Some fans escape by climbing over the fence at the front of the pens. It becomes apparent that a disaster is unfolding, and police stop the match at 6 minutes past three. Desperate people are lifted over the top of the fences, and fans in the upper stand pull others to safety. Police try to free those at the front through the narrow gates near the pitch. There are not enough stretchers, and supporters use advertising hoardings to carry the injured.